estou seguindo a Jesus Cristo. Nesse caminho eu não desisto. Estou seguindo a Jesus Cristo. Atrás não volto, não volto não. Atrás o mundo, Jesus à frente. Jesus é o guia onipotente. Atrás o mundo, Jesus à frente. Atrás não volto, não volto não.
And let's give Jesus a beautiful round of applause. Oh, my brothers, may the name of Jesus be glorified. He opened for us the doors of heaven and has been helping us understand the Word of God, and He has been at our side to bless us. Dr. Soares, what can He do in our lives? The same things that He did in the past. Jesus is already on this day to operate at this moment here in church, you at home, in any country of the world in which you are watching us. Our God wants, can, and will do great things in your life if you simply believe in what He says in His Word. And He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think. Psalm 34, verses 7 and 8 and 9 are known by us for a long time already. I think that almost every Christian knows this psalm and can even quote it by heart. However, many times they do not pay attention to what they are repeating. They are losing blessings. This verse is for us to understand. At the time of ordeal, God is our refuge and our strength, ever-present help. We should invoke this, believe in it, and God will bless us. It says the following, Psalm 34, verse 7. The angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear Him and delivers them. We have three important facts here. The angel of the Lord, the celestial messenger that has the power given by the Lord to solve all our problems, is sent to each person that fears God. They don't need to keep praying, God, place an angel beside me. Lord God, place him here so that he may do this. No, God knows everything. He knows our needs. He is by our side to deliver us. However, we are the agents that do God's work. I need to pray for myself. Pray, send evil away, believe in God so that God's power may operate. God's part is already done. If you accepted Jesus as your Savior, in that minute, an angel of God, an angel of the Lord encamps around you. And to do what? To do God's work. The only requirement, the angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear Him. The only requirement is for you to fear God. What does this mean? To respect. It is not being afraid of God. It is to do what God commands. I respect my God. If He says in the Bible that something is wrong, I don't want to do this. But you know, this person forced me. Oh, my colleague said, no. These things don't work with me. I also was a young one once. And when, I was only 21, right, folks? I mean, sometimes I slip here and I forget that 50 years have already passed from these 21, but then I forget and come back to 21. So it doesn't matter. No, I am young in Jesus. So it is the same thing. They come and the Bible says, my son, if sinners entice you, do not consent. This is not so such a thing. When I realize it's not like this, you did it because you wanted, So don't do it because you have accepted Jesus. It says the angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear Him. Respect God, and the third fact, and delivers them. Will one day God be responsible for telling a lie? He does not lie, He is the truth. There are no promises in the Word of God that were not fulfilled. Sometimes we need to fight because we get relaxed and evil starts to enter, and it enters. But now in the name of Jesus, we will send all evil away. We will demand evil to leave, and evil will have to beat a retreat. Second verse in number 8 that says the following. Oh, and taste and see that the Lord is good. My brother, it is saying we should taste. I don't need to say, God, I am proving you. No, don't do this. I need to taste. I need to find the evil that is attacking me and use the power against him. I need to find the blessing that I need and hold on to it firmly, determining it. If the word guarantees that this blessing belongs to me, it is mine. I take possession I will demand in the name of Jesus, because Jesus said, and whatever you ask, John 14:13, in my name, that I will do. This ask in Greek is the verb ateo. That means to claim, determine, assume, establish, decree. So depending on the situation, if I need something from God, I will claim in the name of Jesus. If I know God has already given me, I will take possession. And if evil is coming, I will determine evil to leave. I will command it to leave. I will rebuke. I will demand. You will have to leave because I am declaring in the name of the Lord Jesus. And by this name, evil will leave. So taste and see. I should not stay like, does God want this or not? I will prove it. I will prove for myself that God wants me to be blessed. I will do a consecration. We'll seek God. What does it mean to seek God? To take a moment to read the Bible, speak with me. You meditate, you pray, you put what you learned inside of your heart, meditate on it, and the word starts to make sense and make sense, and all of a sudden you have the word in your mouth at your disposal. So, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. He will never be evil. He will never be more or less. He is good. He is good to do what? To answer your prayers. Good to operate in your favor. Good to give you victory. Good to fulfill everything that he has promised. For all the promises in him, says the scriptures, for all the promises in him are yes and are for the glory of God. God has promised that it is for his glory. Go for it and you will receive these blessings. Blessed is the man who trusts in him. The man who does not trust will not be successful. Blessed. If you believe in God, you will never be a person that will get disappointed with God. Why do I believe? Because he has shown us the word. Some people say, I believe in God, and not the one that is up there. I know that he is good and he will give me the blessing. No, I believe because he said so and I learned it in his book and he reveals himself in the word. And now I believe, I determine, I demand, I expel. And evil will not touch me at all. No. Blessed, happy, successful is the man, in a general sense, man or woman, who trusts in him. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your understanding. Without being modest, I also understand. I don't understand anything. I am zero. Without Jesus, I am nothing. I can't do anything. I will not do anything. Without Jesus, I can't achieve anything. But with Jesus, I can do everything. Because it is written, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. The word that he gives me strengthens me. I will meditate on it. I will confess it. I know that I will be strengthened by it. And each day I will get better than I was before. The last verse that I said I was going to read is verse 9. Oh, fear the Lord, you his saints. So here we see, saint means separated, sanctified, to belong to God. We are separated. So we need to fear him. But I do fear. No, you don't. Most people do not fear God, folks. People joke with things. It is necessary. They lie without any problems at all. They just lie. Fear the Lord. Respect the Lord God. You are his saints, sanctified by him. And why? There is no want, no lack to those who fear him. Maybe you need to start all over. God, I will start to respect you from today onwards. I will strive to do your will. You will help me, and I will do it. I will show it in the face of the demon that I have done it. But I am in want, Dr. Soares. This is because you are not respecting the Lord. There is a danger for those who accept Jesus. What is the danger, Dr. Soares? It is really serious. To become a religious person, and there are many. They change their voices. It seems like they're holy. They have not changed a thing inside of them. But no one knows this. Then they even make gestures when they are going to speak and all of that. It is not like this. You can be very manly and you can be feminine. Respecting God, nothing will be lacking for you. There's no such thing as becoming religious. No. The religious people are those that follow men's rules. We follow God's rules. Our case is with the Lord. This thing of religion is a fight against what happens down here. Here below, everyone is fighting. The gospel is a higher flight. You can reach God automatically. You live with God and will be a person that stands out in all situations. There is no want for those who serve him, those who fear him, those who serve him. Let's read the word here. Do not say it wrongly was written here. who fear the Lord, you his saints, there is no want for those who fear him, but I am in want. You are not fearing him, I am. No, you're not. You are not understanding. Jesus said in John 16, verse 23 or 24, one of these two verses, until now you have accepted nothing in my name. But how? Why not? When I saw this verse, I said, God, I don't accept this. No, I'm tired of asking. But it wasn't with the revelation. It was without God's revelation, my brother. I received the revelation the day that I was healed of coryza in 1984, 2 years and 4 months. On the day that I understood what I should do, my dear brother, I started to ask, until now you have to ask nothing in my name. It's in verse 24 of John 16. Ask and you will receive. For what? That your joy may be full. God wants to see you happy, but not a fake happiness. No, a true joy, a calm joy. A person may offend you and you can still remain calm. You are not understanding anything, and goes on. Then your patience wins that person. You show the truth and the person will apologize and will be blessed also. Katarina Santos is with us. She is singing a beautiful song, folks. The song is called Your Presence. Jesus said, when you go into your room, close the door. Then you will not see time passing. You don't pay attention to anything else. You only see God's presence. Dear sister, come on up here. This song entered into my heart because I like this part about closing the door. And everyone should enter and close the door. How are you?
Everything is great, Dr. Soares.
What is the story? Enter the room and close the door.
Intimacy, right? It shows intimacy, priorities.
You open yourself to God, tell him
everything,
and receive your blessing.
That's it.
Let's sing with her, folks. Let's applaud Jesus.
We love your presence, Lord. We love you, Lord.
Tua presença traz o céu pra mim. E a essência que havia no jardim. Tudo pra te ver, e quando faço tudo, faço só pra ter tua presença, santa presença. E quando fecho o quarto pra te encontrar, não vejo mais a hora, não vejo o lugar, só tua largo tudo pra te ver, e quando faço tudo, faço só pra ter tua presença, santa presença. E quando fecho o quarto pra te encontrar, não vejo mais a hora, não vejo o lugar, só tua
Oh, glory to God. Let's enter and close this room, folks. Let's take our watches and get lost. Let's not look at where we are. No, it's here where God is, and it is here where God will bless. Jesus said, when you pray, go into your room, and when you have shut your door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly. Blessed be to God. And there are so many people being blessed here in our country and abroad also. Play for me the testimonies of the sponsors.
The Grace of God Church remains determined in making the name of Jesus and all his benefits known around the world. In Portugal, the testimonies confirm the Lord's work.
I did surgery 15 days ago in my chest, and I had symptoms of cancer under my arm. So I came here to receive my healing.
And now, could you raise your arm? How far before the prayer?
I couldn't raise my arm.
You couldn't even raise them?
The doctors did not allow me.
And what about now?
And now I tried to do it, and I clapped my hands. Look, up here.
This is so beautiful, folks.
I came seeking for my healing and received it.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
What a beautiful God. Look at this. Oh, Jesus, this is so beautiful.
God is glorified when we testify of the wonders we received.
Dr. Soares, it is my pleasure to greet you. My name is Theo Delaglia, and I want to witness what God has been doing in my life. I thank you, Dr. Soares, for bringing the Grace of God ministry here to the city of Lima. I am restored after 3 strokes. Nowadays, I am healed, I am strong, and in the name of Jesus, thanks to God and thanks to you, may God bless you.
For the sponsors, taking part of God's work is a privilege.
I was sponsor before I started going to church. But then I had a grandson that had 2 babies, and I got full of debts. So I stayed 6 months without sponsoring. When I was sponsoring, doing everything right, standing firm, I took bags of food for other sisters at church that said they were in need at home. After I stopped sponsoring, they said, "Sister, have you forgotten us?" And I got sad because I stopped sponsoring, but now I can. Because I have already felt in my skin what happens when I stop sponsoring. We must never do that.
I'm a sponsor of the Faith Show because I understand the necessity that we have to gain souls to the kingdom of God. This, for me, is something that brings joy to my heart. May God's kingdom grow.
Arise in the Lord, because the right time to do God's work is now.
Amen. Did you see that Portuguese woman? She had an innocent face and said, "Jesus healed me." Cancro means cancer. It left her arm. Doing God's work is worth it, folks. Many people are learning the ways of the Lord and are being blessed. If you are still not a sponsor and have not felt the calling, it is not with you that I'm talking to. But if God called you, come because it's wonderful. It does good to participate in God's work. I will ask now for the workers to pass by the registration. And who is still not a sponsor, get a form, fill it out. Give me this part because I will pray for you. On the last day of the month, I consecrate myself for 24 hours. And how do I pay? Afterwards, go to the bank and make a deposit. Today, it's only the registration. Get it, fill it out, because the enemy does not want you to have God's presence around you. The angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear him, respect him, and delivers them. Then you make your registration, and arriving at Ned Bank, you will go directly to the cashier and tell him, "I want to make a deposit. You may take this payment bill, but you can't pay with it anymore. We will have a new one soon." Then, arriving there, the account is here. Pay attention. It will appear here on the screen. Cashier's receipt is on the top here. Counter presentation. And there is a number here. It is the branch code number 103910. And the account number is 101-191-9540. 101-191-9540. That's it. If you prefer to deposit at the First National Bank, go to any branch and make the deposit there, because we are in need these days. My brother, it is a lot of work, and God is using us in the name of Jesus, and will use more for the glory of the Lord. If you are at home, call our helpline to make the registration now. The number is 27021-911-5676. 27021-911-5676. Let's now make a beautiful study, folks. about the day that Jacob found out that his son was alive. You know that Joseph was Jacob's favorite son, the son of his beloved Rachel, that later died while giving birth to his second son with her. He was called Benjamin. And Jacob was really sad, and Joseph was a man of God. He sought God. Jacob did not love him only because he was the son of Rachel. No, he was a promising person. But his brothers were used by the devil. His brothers, they made up a story that a wild animal had killed him. They sold him as a slave. He went to Egypt. He became a slave of Potiphar, who worked for Pharaoh. But this man was God's anointing and was respected in the house of Potiphar. Later, Potiphar's wife wanted to have an affair with him. He ran from her. She inverted the story, said that he tried to abuse her. He was in prison. There, he paid a high price, but there God blessed him. A butler and a baker appeared, and he said, "Look, this will happen. Both of them had dreams. You will be restored to your place these next few days." This one was the butler. And the baker told him, and he said, "I'm sorry, you will lose your head," and lost it. When he told the butler, "When you go back, remember me," and the butler forgot him. He stayed 2 more years in prison. But he did not get upset with him and all of that, because when he left prison, he did not search the woman and told her, "Evil woman, you took 2 years of my life, you lied, worthless." No. He left prison to become the prime minister of Egypt. His brothers went to buy bread because there was a big famine, grains, better saying, and he found a way for them to bring him his younger brother. He made him stay. Afterwards, he said to call his father, and Pharaoh gave many things for his father. Now I have already spoken a lot. Let's go to Genesis 45. I had to do more or less a presentation of the story because some would not understand. Genesis 45. Genesis is the first book of the Bible. The first book is Genesis. If you open the Bible, it's in Genesis, then come Exodus, then Leviticus and others. It says the following, verse 24. So he sent his brothers away and they departed, and he said to them, "See that you do not become troubled along the way." We can see that Joseph was a responsible man. Brothers, do not become troubled along the way, because when there is quarreling at your house, if the wife quarrels with the husband and the husband with the wife, the marriage will end. The sons will all become rebellious. Many sad things will happen. And he did not want more for sad things to happen. He spoke clearly to his brothers, "See that you do not become troubled along the way." Then they went up out of Egypt and came to the land of Canaan, to Jacob, their father, and they told him, saying, "Joseph is still alive, and he is governor over all the land of Egypt." What happened with old Jacob? He fainted, folks. Look at this. And Jacob's heart stood still because he did not believe them. Jacob knew that God would not fail him, that the story did not make sense. "But Father, believe in me. He died. We got the remains. Here's the tunic filled with blood." It was the blood of an animal that they killed to be able to mislead him. They acted badly. But Jacob waited on God, "You will not let me die without knowing the truth." And now he found out. So his heart stood still. And it says like this, "But when they told him all the words which Joseph had said to them, and when he saw the carts which Joseph had sent to carry him, the spirit of Jacob, their father, revived. Then Israel said, 'It is enough. It's over. The problem is over. You were evil. We're wicked to your brother. He was also sold as a slave.' The true story was this one. But the God that I serve is Joseph's God also. He honored him, and you were jealous of him. Now it's enough. You will not talk about this anymore. You are my sons. He is also my son. I will go and be with him." Look how understanding this old man was. "I will do God's will," and went. Then Israel said, "It is enough. Joseph, my son, is still alive. I will go and see him before I die." And what happened after that? We have many good lessons here, but time is short. I won't be able to say everything. Chapter 46 is the verse 1. So Israel took his journey with all that he had and came to Beersheba and offered sacrifices to the God of his father Isaac. Jacob was a man of faith. The Lord God revealed himself as the God of Abraham and after God of Isaac. Now it could be the God of Jacob, and he was. Jacob had many experiences with him. But he didn't go running to see his son. First of all, he went to the house of God there in Beersheba. There he had a great experience with God and offered sacrifices to the God of his father Isaac. Then God spoke to Israel. His name was also Israel. In the visions, in the night, and said, Jacob, Jacob. And he said, here I am. Whenever God speaks to you, do not run away. Enter your room as Katarina sings. Open your heart. And God starts to make you understand the word. He is speaking to you. He won't speak in the ear. No. Then you attend to him. Here I am, Lord. Speak to me. I want to understand. I remember once in a Monday prayer meeting, I was one of the last rows of the corridor, and very last corridor. And a businessman was on the last row, and it was a blessed meeting. We could feel God's presence. He spoke in tongues. I answered in tongues. We talked without knowing what we were saying. It seemed like we were longtime friends. He was, Papa, Papa. I looked at him, here it is, good folks. And when you and when you enter in God's presence, I get emotional, and my nose is jealous. I don't know yours. This nose needs to accept Jesus. The eye tears, and the nose starts to tear also. Oh, dear God, convert my nose. So then, folks, I did not want that to end, and I felt that it would end, and said, Jesus, don't let it stretch this meeting. I need more. I need more. And there, many things of my life were solved. You should enter the room and close the door, right? Then he said like this. So he said, I am God, the God of your father. Do not fear to go down to Egypt, for I will make of you a great nation there. God knows everything, my brother. He has a plan for you that you can't even imagine. Maybe you don't even care about your life. Get involved with sin, with wrong things. Don't do this, no. Do not separate yourself from God. No, you need to take these things out and have God in you. You need to shout, cry before him. Love him. Oh, my brother, feel his presence. I will go down with you to Egypt. What a good thing. He would not go by himself. No, God would go with him. Who would be capable of harming him? No one. If God goes with you to your work, to end your marriage, if he goes with you on a trip, no one will harm you. Nothing bad will happen to you. I will go down with you to Egypt, and I will also surely bring you up again. And Joseph will put his hand on your eyes. This meant that he would die beside Joseph, his beloved. And Joseph then would close his eyes at that moment when he died. And what else did he do? Then Jacob arose from Beersheba, and the sons of Israel carried their father Jacob. And who else? Their little ones and their wives in the carts which Pharaoh had sent to carry him. So they took their livestock and their goods which they had acquired in the land of Canaan and went to Egypt, Jacob and all his descendants with him, his sons and his sons, his sons, his daughters and his sons' daughters, and all his descendants he brought with him to Egypt. I ask you, where are the sons of the church members going to the disco? To enjoy life. This is wrong. Your daughters, if Jesus comes back today, will you go with him alone? You will, because they won't go. You did not prepare them. No one there said they would not go to Egypt. I won't. I will stay here. I won't leave this land here. No, everyone entered. They took the sons and the grandsons. Look how beautiful this is. His sons' daughters and his sons' sons. My dear brother, it is you and your household. Put this in your heart. God wants to make you a great blessing. I will pray with you now. Stand up, because I want to cry out on your behalf. This cry is very important. Close your eyes. Concentrate your faith now. Father, we are praying because we are in danger, Father. Our children are not with us. Our grandchildren are not with us. Our parents are not with us. Father, look at this person that is praying. She is meeting a husband that is not saved. What type of marriage is this going to be, Father? One focused on the things of the flesh and the other for things of the spirit. This man is dating a woman that is not saved. How will this marriage prosper, Father? God, this will increase the divorce statistics. Increase divorce. This is not your plan. Your plan is for these people to grow, to develop, that they may raise a family that fears God, that respects each other, a family that does your will. Father, I am praying now to bless these people, to invoke your power over them. Oh my God, and there are people praying in front of the TV that are in great need now. You have spoken to these hearts. Oh my God, I unite my faith with the faith of these people. I rebuke all evil that is in their lives. And I say, leave, go away, release these people. I'm not asking, I am commanding, I am ordering now. Get your disease, your infirmity, get now your lack of luck and leave, demon. Leave with all that is yours. You enter to harm, but you are tied up, and I am commanding you to leave. This is an order now. Disappear in the name of Jesus Christ. I am determining. Leave, leave now. Command, my brother, your disease, your infirmity, your problem to leave. It will not continue. You have lost the battle. Jesus is giving the victory. Oh, dear Jesus, come and bless us now, Jesus. Come and heal. Come transform in the name of the Lord Jesus. I tie up all evil. I determine, leave these people's jobs, leave the schools, leave the relationships. All evil leave in the name of Jesus Christ. Embrace these people now, Father. Oh my God. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen, brothers. You may sit now, Maestro. Let's watch the real-life drama, shall we?
In 2008, I started to have panic syndrome attacks. I passed my son's guard to his father. I lost my job because of the disease, and my father passed away as well.
She was always laying down with depression. She slept all day long and cried a lot.
It was a very difficult period. Still in 2008, I managed to get a new job. I used to go more to the hospital than to work. I got a leave of absence, and in 2011, the government cut my pension and I started to run out of money.
She only thought about dying.
In the middle of 2012, I was watching Faith Show and Dr. Soares started to speak. It seemed he knew all about my life because he started to talk to me for a person who was upset, sad, and thinking there was nothing that could be done, but Jesus has something good. And as I watched it, I started to get better and the need to find a job also. A friend needed someone to take care of her grandmother. Watching the Faith Show, I thought, if those people are being healed in the real-life drama, why can't I be healed as well? So I started to take care of this lady, and she went to the Grace of God Church. I used to take her to the Grace of God Church because she wanted to watch the services. It was when I started to get calmer, more peaceful, and more controlled. It was when I started to have more reasons to be happy. I wasn't afraid of getting out.
I started to see a smile on her face. I started to see transformation in her life.
With the little I earned, I became a sponsor, first of all, because I said, it's wonderful to see lives being reached. I heard Dr. Soares preaching on TV and saw how much it edified me. And for me, to be a sponsor is something that brings the house of the Lord to come to you at any moment. And everything that's spoken and preached there reaches your soul.
After that, she got job opportunities. She got a wonderful job that made her even travel abroad.
And I talked with my pastor about not wanting to be alone, of having someone.
As I didn't know anyone, I turned up at the door of the church and I was there waiting alone.
We met at the door of the church and it all started because the woman that invited him told me that his life was completely destroyed.
At the beginning, I was living with my mother and I continued drinking.
When I started to pray for him, for God to transform him, then some feelings started to appear.
When I started to go to church, I had an encounter with the Word, you know? They went on explaining, and I started to have each day more and more a desire to go to church. And it was when I quit drinking, we started to talk more seriously.
He got baptized a few years ago, but he stopped going to church. On September 24th, 2017, we got engaged at church. And on November 18th, we did our civil marriage.
She represents to me strength, great strength, because of her prayers, because of her dedication. Today, I define myself as a victorious man.
I thought I would die at any moment. This was the symptom I had inside of me. Today, it's a new life. With Jesus, I was transformed. Everything changed.
Today I see that my sister is complete. She's a new person. The woman we knew before getting sick was back. Happy, excited, smiling, singing.
God's work was beautiful in my life. It was a blessing. Everything is possible for those who believe, for those who seek Jesus. There's nothing in the world that God cannot transform.
Glory to God. This is beautiful. There's nothing that God cannot transform. This is a good word for those who are with many problems in life, huge problems, and want to do things by the strength of man. It will not work. Do it through God, and it will work. In the name of Jesus. Sister Eliana, tell me, Sister Eliana, what news do you have for us?
Dr. Soares, we are talking about an amazing movie that many people have already seen, but those who haven't watched it need to. It's called Two Steps from Hope, and it will teach people to trust in God even in the face of great adversity.
Sister Eliana, this book on the right side of those who are looking, called 500 Outlines,
This
book is very good, Sister
Eliana. This book is very good. Many preachers have already recommended it, but it is not only for preachers, whereas for those who like to study the Word of God, it's a great tip. There are 500 Bible study outlines.
You can show to everyone all those products as well. It is next door. Pay a visit when the service is over. In Rio, it is next door to the Church of Tintulu. They're in the final stop at the BRT of Madureira. From anywhere, you can call us. We have a helpline if you need more information, and the number is 27-021-911-5676. 27-021-911-5676. Call us. I will repeat, 27-021-911-5676. 27-021-911-5676. And we have our website that is ongracesouthafrica.com. Let's now go to the first question, shall we?
Doctor, is it a sin to make a tattoo in honor of God?
Yes. He has a beard that looks like those prophets of the movies, eh, folks? The Holy Bible says you shall not make any cuttings in your flesh. Don't do it because you are not allowed. Marks and cuttings, even more as a tribute to God. It is a trend we have that makes me sad. There are people whose skin is fully painted and it will be there until they die. It doesn't come out anymore. This is serious stuff. They can take it out. It will come out just a little. I know a man who wrote here, Jesus is the Lord. I think he said, Dr. Suarez, it hurts. Every laser section burns. It burns it all here, and it hasn't come out yet. Don't do this. No, there are better things for you to do. Put Jesus in your heart instead of writing something here. There are people who write the name of their boyfriend when they break up. Someone will write my name, and the newspaper will interview him someday. Oh, mercy me. Second question.
Dr. Suarez, what do I have to do to understand the Bible?
You have to read with an open heart and become a student. I've read the Bible since I was 7 when I became literate and started to read. I am 64 now, and it is so good to read, to meditate. Reading only for reading is not worth anything. Apostle Paul, the great Paul, said that the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life, gives revelation. What is important is for the Holy Spirit to open your understanding. At that moment, when it is only you and God there, that moment, you start reading and reading and reading, and you start growing. This revelation, every revelation, God says, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will achieve the purpose for which I sent it. So this revelation will not come empty. No, every word that goes out of my mouth, it will not return to me empty. It will come with power to do this. And if you don't allow it to operate, it will stay by your side. And it will be a testimony against you. Because you felt the word, you know that God talked to you. But sometimes, because of a silly thing, maybe even lack of doctrine at home. The gospel in Brazil is recent. People did not belong to Jesus. I am not saying that the gospel entering here was recent. That episode we study in history classes in 1500 and something in which there was the French invasion in Rio de Janeiro. It actually wasn't a French invasion, but rather the Calvinists running away from persecution in France. They even thought about creating an Antarctic France. I don't know if they thought about it or not, but they were killed, being hanged. Since that time, we've already had the gospel here. Gospel, and the missionaries kept coming. Some of them were arrested, others were killed, until the gospel became popular. I got tired of being invited to go to the police station when I started, folks, in the countryside here of São Paulo. I already knew what would happen. Police, yes, sir. Follow me, yes, sir. If he is an authority, you have to go with him. What did you come here to do? Preach the gospel. And this and that. You can't do it. The law says I can. Sometimes if they spoke louder, I did the same, folks. And God gave us the victory in the name of Jesus. And today, thanks to God, almost half already belong to Jesus, and soon it will be the majority. Oh, glory to God. I don't want the devil to have anyone in this world. Everybody should belong to Jesus. Doesn't matter the church, brother. If they preach the word of God, blessed be the Lord. Stand firm with God that will give you the blessing in the name of Christ. Well, sponsors, I've already asked, but said, but reminding, go to the bank and make a deposit in the next few hours when the bank opens. Go to the cash machine and make a deposit. Our branch code has the number 103910. 103910. And the account number at Ned Bank is 101-191-9540. That's all you need. Let's now open our hearts, shall we?
Dr. Soares, I am confused. Not long ago, my wife left me, but I would like to reunite with her. Each day, I try to make amends with God and do everything right. However, my ex-wife doesn't want to reunite and says that she wants to go to the court of justice to claim her rights. On that account, can I get divorced and be happy with another person?
You are too hasty. You need to enter into a period of prayer, man. You have to seek. Don't you like her? You said before that you like her, God, this and that. I'm wrong. Maybe she is making things difficult because you went really far. And she is not silly, right? And if you really change, who knows, right? Go slowly. What happened? Do you want to get into another problem? You get divorced, get married again, and then you have another divorce. Enough of entering into problems. You didn't have the wisdom to manage the situation, and neither did she. Let's now go to the Grace TV moment, shall we?
For me, Grace TV is a blessing in my house. Every day we gather in the living room to watch the services and Dr. Sowadis. It is wonderful to have Grace TV in our house. Now my son leaves his room. He was always locked in his bedroom. For me, seeing him in the living room watching TV with us is a great blessing. Sometimes he says the message spoke to him. He was crazy about a shooting game he played, and one day I said to him, "Someday, Dr. Sowadis will speak to you." I used to turn on Grace TV on the TV in his bedroom, and one day he said to me that Dr. Sowadis spoke to him through the Word, and then he never played that game anymore. You are losing a great blessing. Every day we are fed with the Word, and this is important for our lives. Apart from us being fed, the others in our house that don't go to church are also nourished.
How many houses there are children that don't leave the bedroom? There are husbands that don't get out, wives that have problems, daughters. Install Grace TV, folks. I will ask you to pass by the brochure. Take it for free. You don't pay anything, and if you don't like it, throw it away. Take it home. Pray about it, watch the channels and everything. And this month, until the end of the month, all channels are available for those who have any package. Maybe someone is paying only the first package. That is the cheapest one, and that has the evangelical channels, and that's what matters. But if you want to watch the others, it will be available until the end of the month. So I have decided, what should I do? Call our helpline. The number is here. If you're at home, you can call us now. The number is 27-021-911-5676. Repeat, 27-021-911-5676. Our website is on gracesouthafrica.com. Do you have WhatsApp, Dr. Swadis? 27-079-496-9037. Register now. Install it to solve the problems in your house. That man that is thinking about divorce, that wants his wife back, but she wants a divorce. You can't have this inclination on your heart. You have to pray first. Install Grace TV, invite her to watch a program, and let God do his work. Let me pray for those who are at home now. Father, first of all, I pray for those who are at home. I tie all evil that is in these lives. I determine to leave, to go away. You are forbidden to continue. My God, send power now. Answer the prayer of these people. Evil, leave in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's stand up now so that we can pray. Pastor Jaime is here, Michael is here, and we will pray so that God may cover us with his power now. Bow your head, close your eyes. Father, we are praying. We are coming into your presence. We are here to do your will. And God, there are so many people that need your help, that need your power. They need, oh God, a touch from your hands. And God, we are coming now with, oh God, our hearts open. Father, show us what is wrong, what hinders you from operating. Because Father, it is impossible to live without you operating. God, we are praying now. We want to put our houses in order. This evil needs to go away. It could be the worst temptation that controlled this person. And since that day, this person doesn't have peace, doesn't have health, doesn't have happiness, doesn't have the willingness to fight and to win. But Father, this temptation will leave now. I ask you to send fire from heaven to burn it completely. This is something from the enemy that he will be defeated now. My Lord, send your power, send your authority, operate in us. You are already operating now. Go deeper, my brother. Cry out to God. Don't keep your mouth shut, no. Ask God wisdom for you to pray as you need. If God brought you here today and it was God that brought you, it is because he wants to operate in your life. God doesn't want you to leave this place without being blessed, no.